there. How's life going so far? Good or no good? Either way, today's stars will put a smile on your face. So if you need some motivation to keep going, to keep grinding, here it is. The all-new BMW X8M is halfway here. I say that because we have spy pics and videos for you, but it's so new that there are no pictures of its design. But we already know quite a bit about this newest addition to the luxury performance SUV club. Stay tuned, have fun, and maybe you get a little motivation back. Stay hot! So, if we can't see the new X8M in full for the moment, we have to look at the closest that we have. But first, a basic description. The X8M will be something between a BMW X7 and a Rolls-Royce Cullinan, with a little bit of Audi Q8. It's like the Cullinan and the X7 had a baby, and somehow it has a roof other than these two. It will be just as big or even bigger than the X7 with a coupe-like roofline, and that's because it's based on the X7, obviously. And you guessed it, yes, this one will be an SUV coupe, whatever that means. No, seriously, we know what an SUV coupe can look like. Just look at the BMW X6 or the Mercedes GLC or even the Audi Q8. What we know and what we can see or imagine under that camouflage are the new and improved, if you want to say that, front grills. I won't start here because I like those grills on the new M3 and M4, but on a big SUV it looks like the BMW design team has lost their mind or something. By the way, here is the video of the new M3 and M4. Enjoy. I can't explain this. I mean, I heard more complaints about the whole new front design than praises. But we have to give it to BMW for doubling down even in the face of complete defeat. That wasn't a compliment. And yes, it was a pretty lame joke. Let's continue. Apart from the new grills, the X8M and the new facelift version of the X7, as well as all new facelift models, will come with the new headlights. I call them splitted headlights, because they have two parts each, you get it? I won't say anything. Let's wait till we see the X8M in full, and then I will give my final opinion. The X8M is not better in everything than its little brother, the X7, because it's very likely that the X8M will have no option to carry 7 passengers, because of the roof. What it will get for sure is the new improved iDrive infotainment system combined with a massive screen. Of course, this beast needs 4-wheel drive and the transmission will come from the X7. And it's an 8-speed automatic one. Now let's talk about the engine. I won't talk about the standard X8 because, well, this is no channel for slow cars. The X8M will most likely have the same engine as the BMW X7M 50i. And that's good news, because the X7M is powered by a 4.4-liter V8 twin turbo with 530 horsepower and a 0-60 time of 4.7 seconds. Or maybe they will go all ballistic and put the competition one in the normal X8M, which is basically the same engine, but it puts out 625 horsepower and a quicker 0-60 time, namely 3.8 seconds. I don't know if there will be a competition and a standard X8M, but regardless of which one comes out, it will be big in numbers, because of the next fact. Maybe the X8M will have an additional hybrid system. And BMW has already electric motors ready for exactly this reason. Each one of these electric motors puts out at least 200 horsepower. So even if they only add one, the BMW X8M could have well over 800 horsepower. Now wouldn't that be nice? Last thing for today is my estimation of the price of one of these things. Now if you ask me, I would say that the X8M won't start under 120,000 euros. There are some people who say that it won't start under 150,000. But I'm optimistic. Once again, you have reached the end of one of our videos. How was it? Tell us. Tell us if you like what you see and also which cars you want to see next. I hope we gave you a little sneak peek of the new X8M, and if not, just wait a bit longer, because only the future will tell us what it looks like exactly. Have a great one, guys, and as always, keep it fluid.